The Color Purple by Alice Walker. Celie is the main protagonist of this novel. Celie is a poor, uneducated 14-year-old girl living in the southern United States in the early 90s. She writes letters to God because her father, Alfonso, beats and rapes her constantly. Alfonso has already impregnated Celie once, a pregnancy that resulted in the birth of a girl she named Olivia. But Alfonso took the baby away shortly after her birth, and Celie thinks he killed her. Celie then has a second child, a boy named Adam, whom Alfonso also abducts. Celie's ailing mother dies after cursing Celie on her deathbed. So, Celie is a very poor girl, and she's also an uneducated girl. She is always raped by her father. Actually, Alfonso is her stepfather, but Celie doesn't know about that, and she thinks that Alfonso is her real father. And she gave birth to two children, Olivia and Adam, whom Alfonso take away from her very shortly after their delivery. And Celie and her young sister, she is 12-year-old, Nettie, learn that a man identified only as Mr. wants to marry Nettie. Alfonso refused to let Nettie marry, instead arranging for Mr. to marry Celie. Mr., a widower needing someone to care for his children and keep his house, eventually accepts the offer. Mr. physically, sexually and verbally abuses Celie, and all his children treat her badly as well. So, another person came into their life, that is Mr. Dash. And Mr. Dash wants to marry Nettie, who is Celie's sister. But Alfonso doesn't allow that, because Alfonso has an eye on Nettie too. Alfonso want to have a sexual intercourse with Nettie as well. So he prevents that, and he asks Mr. Dash to marry Celie. And this man marries Celie, and he always abuses her. Shortly thereafter, Nettie runs away from Alfonso and takes refuge at Celie's house, where Mr. makes sexual advances towards her. Celie then advises Nettie to seek assistance from a well-dressed black woman that she saw in the general store a while back. The woman has unknowingly adopted Olivia and was the only black woman that Celie had ever seen with money of her own. Nettie is forced to leave after promising to write. Celie, however, never receives any letter and concludes that her sister is dead. Time passes, and Harpo, Mr. Sun, falls in love with an assertive girl named Sophia, who becomes pregnant with Harpo's baby, and despite initial resistance from Mr., Harpo marries Sophia. Harpo and Sophia have 5 more children in short order. Celie is amazed by Sophie's defiant refusal to submit to Harpo's attempt to control her. As Harpo is kinder and gentler than his father, Celie advises him not to try to dominate Sophia. Harpo temporarily follows Celie's advice but falls back under Mr. Sway. Celie, momentarily jealous of Harpo's genuine love of Sophia, then advises Harpo to beat her. Sophia fights back, however, and confronts Celie. A guilty Celie apologizes and confides in Sophia about all the abuse she suffered at Mr.'s hands. She also begins to consider Sophia's advice about defending herself against further abuse from Mr. So here we see the life of Harpo, who was the son of Mr. Dash. And he marries a girl named Sophia, and they live a kind of okay life. And after that, Celie was very, very disappointed with the genuine love of Harpo, because she is a person who is always disturbed or made fun by all the others. And she is always abused sexually, physically, mentally, and she's very, very sad because of all these things. And while seeing Harpo's genuine love towards Sophie, she feels somewhat jealous, and she asks Harper to beat Sophie. And after that, Sophie defend Harper, and Sophie get to know about the idea or the black nature of Seeley. And Seeley then confronts about all the painful events that she had failed in her life, and Sophie advises her to fight everything back. Chuck Avery, a jazz and blues singer, and Mr.'s longtime mistress fall ill, and Mr. takes her into his house. Seeley, who has been fascinated by photos of Chuck she found in Mr.'s belongings, is thrilled to have her there. Mr.'s father expresses disapproval of the arrangement, reminding Mr. that Chuck has 3 out of wedlock children, though Mr. indirectly implies to him that he is those children's father. Mr.'s father then leaves in disgust. While Chuck is initially rude to Seeley, who has taken charge of nursing her, the two women become friends, and Seeley soon finds herself infatuated with Chuck. So here comes another character, who is Chuck Avery. And Chuck Avery was an ex-girlfriend or ex-mistress of Mr. Tash. And she has fallen ill, and she is now staying at the home of Seeley. And Chuck doesn't like Seeley at first, but after that they become good friends. And after that, Seeley was very fascinated by her beauty. Chuck is a white woman, and she loves her picture and her beauty as well. And Seeley soon get infatuated with Chuck. Frustrated by Harper's domineering behavior, Sophia moves out, taking her children with her. Several months later, Harper opens a juke point where a fully recovered Chuck performs nightly. Chuck decided to stay when she learned that Mr. beat Seeley when she is away. Chuck and Seeley grow closer. So, getting frustrated by Harper's beating and all the dominating behavior, Sophia moves out of the house with her children. And after that, Harper opens a juke point where Chuck performs every night. And then, Chuck decides to stay about knowing about Mr.'s behavior. So Chuck initially doesn't know that Mr. Dash was this much cruel hearted, and after seeing his beating towards Seeley, she continues her stay in their house, and Chuck and Seeley grow very closer. Sophia returns for a visit and promptly gets into a fight with Harper's new girlfriend. And after that, Harper gets a new girlfriend. Squeak knocking Squeak's teeth out in town one day while Sophie's enjoying a day out with her new boyfriend, a prize fighter, and their prospective children, she gets into a physical fight with the mayor after his wife. Miss Millie insults Sophia and her children. The police arrive and brutally beat Sophia, leaving her with a cracked skull, broken ribs, her face rendered nearly unrecognizable, and blind in one eye. She is subsequently sentenced to 12 years in jail. So, and after that, Sophia gets into a physical fight with the mayor's wife, and the mayor's wife complained a charge against her. So she was beaten very brutally by the policeman, and she was taken to the jail, and she was sentenced to 12 years in jail. Squeak, a mixed race woman, and Sheriff Hodges, illegitimate niece, attempts to blackmail the sheriff into releasing Sophia, resulting in her being raped by her uncle. Squeak cares for Sophia's children while she is incarcerated, and the two women develop a friendship. Sophia is eventually released and begin working for Miss Millie, which she detests. Despite being newly married to a man called Grady, Chuck instigates a sexual relationship with Seeley on her next visit. One night, Chuck asks Seeley about her sister. So,
Here, Shucks Avery is again married to a man called Grady, and then also she continues her sexual relationship with Seely. On one night, Shuck asks Seely about her sister, and Shuck helps Seely recover a letter from Nitty that Mr. has been hiding from her for decades. The letter indicates that Nitty befriended a missionary couple, Samuel and Corinne. The well-dressed woman that Seely saw in the store, whom Nitty eventually accompanied to Africa to do missionary work. Samuel and Corinne have unwittingly adopted both Adam and Olivia. Corinne, noticing that her adopted children resemble Nitty, wonders if Samuel fathered the children with her. Increasingly suspicious, Corinne tries to limit Nitty's role in her family. So, as we all know, Nitty is the sister of Seely, and she is now staying with a missionary couple. And this missionary couple has adopted Seely's children, and they are Adam and Olivia. So, this missionary couple adopted Adam and Olivia, and they are taking care of them as their own children. And when Nitty comes to their life, this Corinne is the wife of that missionary man, and that is Samuel. So, Corinne is the wife of Samuel, and she finds that this kid resembles Nitty. So, while seeing this, she has got some suspicion about these two people, like if they are having any sexual relationship or any adulterous relationship with each other. And slowly, she begins to limit Nitty in her family. Through her letters, Nitty reveals that she has become disillusioned with her missionary work. Corinne becomes ill with a fever. Nitty asks Samuel to tell her how he adopted Olivia and Adam. Realizing that Adam and Olivia are Seely's children, Nitty then learns that Alfonso is actually her and Seely's stepfather. Their biological father was a store owner whom white men lynched because they resented his success. She also learned that their mother suffered a mental collapse after the death of her husband, and that Alfonso exploited the situation in order to control their mother's considerable wealth. So after that, this Corinne has fallen ill, and it asks Samuel about Olivia and Adam. And Samuel tells everything about Olivia and Adam and how they have adopted them. Well, and by hearing all those things, Nitty realized that Adam and Olivia are Seely's children. She also understood that Alfonso is not their real father, and Alfonso is their stepfather. Actually, their biological father was a shop owner. All these white men killed him. And this Alfonso was a very crooked man, exploited their mother in order to grab her wealth. Nitty confesses to Samuel and Corinne that she is in fact the children's biological aunt. The gravely ill Corinne refuses to believe her until Nitty reminds her of her previous encounter with Seely in the store. Later, Corinne dies, finally having accepted Nitty's story. Meanwhile, Seely visits Alfonso, who confirms Nitty's story. Seely begins to lose some of her faith in God, which she confides to Shuck, who explains to Seely her own unique religious philosophy. Shuck helps Seely to realize that God is not someone who has power over her like the rest of the men in Seely's life. Rather, God was an it and not a who. Actually, after all these things, Nitty tells the reality about the children, and she confesses that she is their biological aunt, and Corinne refuses to believe that. And finally Corinne believes her, and Corinne dies. After that, Celie visits Alfonso, and Alfonso also confirms Nettie's story. And Celie was very desperate, and she slowly lose her hope and faith in God. Celie, having had enough of her husband's abuse, decides to leave Mr. along with Shagan Squeak, who is considering a singing career of her own. Celie puts a curse on Mr. before leaving him for good. Celie settles in tennis and supports herself as a seamstress. She learns that Mr. suffering from a considerable decline in fortune after Celie left him has changed dramatically, and Celie begins to call him by his first name, Albert. Albert proposes that they marry in the spirit as well as in the flesh, but Celie declines. So, after all these events, Celie goes away from Mr. and she considers leaving him. And she loves to live with Shuck and Squeak. And after Celie's left, Mr. Dash slowly loses his fortunes. And well, that time, Mr. Dash really understood the value of Celie. Alfonso dies. Celie inherits his land and moves back into her childhood home. Around this time, Shug falls in love with Jermaine, a member of her band, and this new crushes Celie. Shug travels with Jermaine all the while writing postcards to Celie. Celie pledges to love Shug even if Shug does not love her back. So this is where Alice Walker really portrays the lesbian relationship. So in this thing, Shug is having another relationship with a man called Jeremy. And Celie was very disappointed by saying all these things. But Celie says that even if she doesn't love her, she will not stop loving her. She will continue her love for Shug. Meanwhile, Nettie and Samuel marry and prepare to return to America. Before they leave, Adam marries Tashi, an African girl. Following an African tradition, Tashi undergoes a painful ritual of female circumcision and facial scarring. In solidarity, Adam undergoes the same facial scarring ritual. So, Adam, the son of Celie, marries a girl called Tashi, an African girl. As Celie realizes that she is content in her life without Shug, Shug returns having ended her relationship with Jermaine. Nettie, Samuel, Olivia, Adam and Tashi all arrive at Celie's house. Nettie and Celie reunite after 30 years and introduce one another to their respective families as the novel ends. So this is the climax of the novel. And that is the union of the family, the reunion of the family after 30 years. So, while all these years, both the sisters and their family members have been going through a lot of struggles and pain, Celie and Nettie, the two main protagonists of the play, Celie, a very poor girl, unknown of the evil things of the world, and Nettie, somewhat kind of a brave girl, but she has also suffered a lot because of their stepfather. And And they all reunite, and Nettie is the one who have taken care of Celie's children as well. So now all these people reunite, and Adam has come with his wife Tashi as well to see Celie. So this is a wonderful climax with the reunion of all the family members after 30 years.